Gratitude for being able to have a second chance to live.
His story captivated Minnesota and the nation back in 1985. A 17-year-old Cretin High School student flew to the Reno, Lake Tahoe area for Super Bowl weekend with dozens of other Minnesotans. He was the only one, though, to make it home alive. For more than 28 years, George Lamson Jr. has rarely spoken publicly about his story of survival.
Well, this week, 5 Eyewitness News reporter Tom Hauser traveled to Reno, Nevada to tell us why the crash survivor is now breaking his silence.
It sounds like a dream trip for any 17-year-old boy.
Super Bowl 19, the Miami.
Flying off to Lake Tahoe in Reno with your dad for Super Bowl weekend.
We bonded really good that weekend.
The son goes skiing, dad does some gambling, and together you watch the Super Bowl.
The classic Montana.
In 1985, it's a dream come true for George Lamson Jr., a senior at Cretin High School.
We had a really good time together that last weekend.
But fate has a cruel way of turning a dream into a nightmare.
The Galaxy Airlines plane crashed and burned about 2.5 miles south of Reno International Airport.
Seconds after takeoff, Galaxy Airlines Flight 203, carrying 71 passengers and crew, mostly from Minnesota and western Wisconsin, crashes in a huge fireball.
We have found some of the bodies to be at least 3 deep in the aircraft area.
Nearly everyone on board the Lockheed Electra charter plane was killed instantly. Bodies barely recognizable in the wreckage.
Lockheed Electra crashed in Reno, Nevada.
Miraculously, 3 people survived the initial impact. Robert Miggins of Wayzata, George Lamson Sr. of St. Paul, and his son George.
The condition I am in compared to the other people, I feel very, very lucky.
George suffered burns and bruises, but lived to tell his story with his mom and sister at his side in the hospital. And he had hopes his dad would also pull through.
I hear that, like, they told him that I was alive. He started moving his arm around, and he's responding.
But in the days that followed, his dad and Robert Miggins died. Out of 71 people on the plane, George Lamson Jr. is the sole survivor. 28 years later, it's impossible to tell there was a horrific plane crash at this intersection. There's now a Home Depot, a Target store, Starbucks. But believe it or not, that sole survivor, George Lamson Jr. of Minnesota, now lives just over 5 minutes from here.
Losing my dad was a huge hole in my life, so coming here kind of brought me a little closer to him.
George is reluctant to visit the crash site.
The approximate point of impact.
But he spent a few minutes there with me recently, still unable to understand how or why he survived.
I landed out in the middle of the street here. By the time I got to the street, the plane is broken apart. That's where I got thrown out of the street in my seat, so I was able to handle the impact. What I remember is hitting the ground, waking up, seeing the sky, thinking I was dead.
The only visible reminder of the Galaxy Flight 203 disaster is a simple memorial to the victims in a public park several miles from the crash site. It includes a list of all 70 people who perished and the only survivor.
I feel gratitude for being able to have a second chance to live.
George is just one of 14 people to be the only survivor of a commercial plane crash.
When I was 17 years old, I was in a plane accident.
Some of them, including Lamson, are the focus of a new documentary film called Sole Survivor.
I wanted to do something that would explain what I went through and maybe teach somebody that may be going through a difficult time. They could learn from my experience.
After his initial fame that he neither sought or enjoyed, he finished high school at Cretin and a year of college at St. Thomas. But eventually, he was drawn back to Reno, where he's lived very privately since 1990.
I didn't come here consciously to be near my dad, but I realized that by being here, I do feel closer to him.
And when he has bad days, he likes to come to the Galaxy Crash Memorial to remember all 70 people who died and fight occasional bouts of survivor's guilt.
And I carry him around with me all the time. They're with me 24/7.
He talked about his father.
We showed George some of our news coverage from the crash in 1985, much of which he'd never seen.
God, I just feel so bad seeing my sister like that.
It reminded him of the fateful moments before the crash.
When I looked out the window, I saw the ground. So our plane was tilted this way. I'm looking out the window, and I'm still seeing the ground. I should be looking up at stars or wherever. And then we knew something was wrong, and it got very quiet in the cabin.
In his quiet moments now, he still searches for the answer to the question, why is he the only one who survived a tragedy so many did not?
Just look at the simple things, you know, what's important.
Was it just luck?
Nope.
There's more than that.
There's more than that. But I don't know what it is. And I'll find out throughout the course of my life what it is.
Oh, yeah. George Lamson Jr. lives a very private life now in Reno. He works at a casino there. He's divorced, but is the proud father of a 16-year-old daughter. And he'll be back here in Minnesota next week for the Minneapolis premiere of Soul Survivor at the Riverview Theater. And he says he's looking forward to coming back. He does get back to Minnesota more often than he used to visit family and friends. But for a long time, more than 10 years at one point, he didn't come back here.
Yeah, he has such an amazing story to tell. Did they ever figure out why the plane crashed? What caused it to happen?
They did. They actually had a pretty clear reason for this crash. It was really a tragic series of events. Ground workers improperly closed an air start access door beneath the wing. As you can see in this demonstration, after the crash, that door came open on takeoff, and because of the resistance with the wind, it caused major vibrations in the plane, eventually leading the pilots to lose control. The plane ended up crashing just 90 seconds after takeoff, just a couple hundred feet off the ground.
Oh, Tom, where were George and his dad sitting that allowed them to be able to survive the crash?
Well, you know, this NTSB report that we have indicates very clearly where they were was very key to George Sr.'s initial survival and George's long-term survival. They were both near the front of the plane, right at a bulkhead, and the plane broke apart right in front of them. So George Jr. was thrown 40 feet from the plane in his seat, landed on his back on the cushion. His dad, unfortunately, landed on his head and had severe head injuries that he suffered. But initially, 16 people survived the impact, but they were all consumed by the fire because the plane was full of fuel. Very tragic series of events, but remarkably, miraculously, George Lamson Jr. survived, and he'll be back in Minneapolis next week.
Oh, my goodness. And he's fine now. He doesn't have any lasting injuries.
He has a little scar from a burn near his forehead and also one on his hand, but other than that, came out of it almost unscathed, but you can tell he's very conflicted about it. Mm-hmm. Imagine carrying that around with you the rest of your life.
All right. Tom, thanks so much. Appreciate the story.
Well, tickets are available for the Twin Cities premiere of Soul Survivor. It's set for May 30th at the Riverview Theater in Minneapolis. Right now on KSTP.com, you'll find our extended interview with Lamson in Reno, along with the trailer for the Soul Survivor documentary. We also have a link to the NTSB report Tom was just talking about the cause of the plane crash. It's all in our interactive web center at KSTP.com. Well,